Dear fellow Toastmasters, dear guests, last week I became the witness of the following conversation in the changing room of a swimming pool between two girls. No, we won't be able to make it in June or July because there will be that, you know, FIFA World Cup something, and my boyfriend's going to watch it, and he is even going to attend several matches. Oh, really? Is it going to be that long? I mean, longer than a week? Yeah, it's gonna long for the whole month. Really, gosh, what? Why so long? And will there be our national team playing, or haven't they qualified as usual? To tell you the truth, this conversation fueled my assurance that even if you are really far away from football and if you haven't ever shown much interest in that kind of sport, if the term offside means something mysterious to you, still, you may need some basic awareness of the event, which is going to have a really big impact on the all spheres of our life in the country. Economics, cultural, sport events, and so on. So I'm going to provide some basic insights into what is going to happen in June and July of this year in our country. So let us begin with some basics. The history. So this person who's gonna appear is Jules Rimet. Taylor will tell me how to do it correctly. This is a French football administrator who is actually credited with the idea to gather the strongest national teams who will compete for the title of the best in the world. He was the organizer of the first World Cup, which took place in 1930. And now I would like to hear some suggestions. Guess where did it happen?
France.
No. Any more suggestions?
Switzerland.
England.
No.
China.
No.
Japan.
Okay.
From Latin America?
That's right. Actually, it was Uruguay. And there were two major reasons why it happened there. First of all, because this country was the winner of the previous two Olympic tournaments in football. In 1924 and 1928. And the second reason was because the Uruguayan Football Association actually offered to pay for the travel costs to all the countries who were about to compete. Probably that was one of the most important reasons. So, so far we've had 20 World Cups, but only 8 winners. And you can find all of them there on the slide. Interestingly, Brazil, which was actually the most frequent winner, they won the tournament for 5 times, they competed in all the 20 World Cups. So not only the most frequent winner, but also the most frequent participant. So now the format of the game. So what's it all about? How it's all organized? In fact, the format of the game changed several times, but now we have 32 teams which compete in the final tournament. And the final tournament consists of two stages, the group stage and the playoff or the knockout stage. The group stage consists of 8 groups, each comprising 6 teams. And it's really interesting how these teams actually find themselves in the groups. So 16 teams are seeded into the groups. That really looks kind of like that. It means that they are put there automatically, and usually these are the strongest teams which are allocated into the group so that they do not compete with each other at the initial stages of the tournament, so that the whole tournament looks more interesting to the audience. And the other 16 teams, they are put into special pots, and they are drawn into the groups in the ceremony of the special draw. Again, there are some restrictions. For instance, not more than 2 teams from Europe can find themselves in one group. Then, after the group stage, the winners in each group advance to the knockout stage. And there, they gradually advance through quarterfinals, semifinals, to the final, and to the third place match. That's basically the format of the game, and now we go on to see some rules. I'm not going to load you with the details of the game football as itself, but I'm going to show you some basic rules which apply to such world-renowned tournaments as the World Cup. So the most interesting thing is the rule of the golden ball, the silver ball, and no ball, let's say. The first one, it's also called the instant death. That's when the game actually ends as soon as the team scores in extra time. The silver goal is a little bit smoother. It gives the teams the opportunity to play up to the first half, to the end of the first half, and the team which is leading up to the first half actually wins. And the third option is when there is no such rule. It's when the team play the whole extra time up to the end. Then you may ask me, what's it all about? Why they all compete like for a month? For what? For that. This is actually the trophy. It was chosen by FIFA officials, football officials, out of 50 applicants. And this one is actually designed by an Italian sculptor. This is a piece of 18 karat gold, the whole piece. And there are two stripes of semi-precious malachite. And the stripe between them is usually engraved with the name of the last winner of the team, the last winning team. But interestingly enough, the original does not stay with the winning team. Actually, they retain it up to the end of the celebration. And after that, this one is replaced with a replica, which is not the solid piece of gold, but only the golden, the cup with the golden surface. So that's a pity. Now we go on to see actually what is going to happen in Russia in summer. So FIFA World Cup 2018 is going to feature 32 teams. It will take place from the 14th of June to 15th of July. There are some teams which will make their debuts, for instance, Iceland and, if I'm not mistaken, some other team from Africa. The tournament will take place in 11 cities, but on 12 pitches, because Moscow will have two stadiums participating in that. And there are some interesting facts about the whole tournament. So the budget which was approved for this tournament is 660 million rubles. And that is only for the organization of the infrastructure, like stadiums, roads, etc. Not taking into account hotels and all the other things which are also needed to organize such a big event. Then there will be special ambassadors who will represent the host cities. These are famous people who will promote the idea of sport, of healthy lifestyle, of playing football. Then the logo of the tournament, which is this one, it was presented in space. The cosmonauts in the International Space Station counted down and showed this logo to the public, which was later projected onto the surface of the Moscow Bolshoi Theater. So we like it to make in a rather surprising way. Zabivaka, yes. in fact, it was not invented by me. It was invented by a Russian student, Ekaterina Bocharova. This is the mascot, the official mascot of the tournament, the wolf, which will represent the whole event. But there is also another interesting animal, a cat Achilles, who lives in St. Petersburg, and he is supposed to act as the famous octopus Paul. He will predict the scores of all the games. He already started to do it in the Confederations Cup a year ago, and he was really successful, except for one game which ended in a draw, but unfortunately he didn't have the opportunity to choose a draw, he had to choose the winner. So that's how he was unintentionally mistaken. So that's him, by the way. So that's generally it. I would like to end my presentation with encouragement for all of you, especially for those people who are really far away from football, just to have a glimpse, to give it a chance, to see the whole nation standing in a one big emotional approach. That is really interesting. Just try to be involved as a million people around the world. Thank you very much.